Today we are unboxing a new dress once again and also reflecting on why do we always need to buy more dresses, or what do we think that we need more dresses? My name is Joelle and you're watching Fluffy Kawaii Jo, the channel where I try to show you that everybody can be kawaii. I do Lolita videos on Mondays and Thursdays, so if you're new here, please consider subscribing. So now let's open this dress and at the very end I will tell you all about my coordinates. This is Shadow Dream Carnival by Angelique Pretty in a colorway mint, of course. You know by now, mint is my favorite color. And this dress, I've seen it in person in the closet of Rosaline Wonderland Lolita, and I thought it was so pretty. And it's actually an OP that is fully shirred, or at least partially shirred, but it is plus size friendly, which is amazing. So in my case, I was reflecting on what are my icons for my channel, for my personality. I feel like this, I like so many styles, always sweet, but I don't have like a thing go to for my style. Like some people, you see a picture and you instantly realize that it's them. That's actually a good point. I should try and maybe do coordinates like Lovely Lore do, or like other YouTubers do. That would be fun. Anyways, I think that I needed to find something that is me, that says Fluffy Kawaii Jo. And I think this wig, a lot of people associate me with it because it's also in my avatar icon on YouTube, Facebook, everywhere basically. And so right now it's all damaged at the bottom, but I actually love it. I keep loving it. Anyways, so I like this, but I also like mint and pink together, and I realized that I have a lot of already mint dresses and I really love those colors, and I would like to buy more in that colorway to make not only my wardrobe more cohesive, but also my image as a YouTuber, as a person, as a Lolita, more cohesive. I want to be the mint and pink, or just mint girl, and then when people think of mint, they think of me. Maybe that's a little bit ambitious, but when they think of me, they think of mint and pink. Maybe that's it. And my studio, I'm also planning to paint it mint and pink, so yeah. So in my case, I wanted to buy more dresses in those colors because I want to go to wearing more of these colors. I'm not saying that I won't wear any maroon or navy, those two colors I have a lot of dress in too, and I love those colors, but I would like more dresses in those colors. Anyways, let's go to this one. It was a set with three pieces, and we have socks and the head bow that goes with the dress because it's a special set. So the socks, I don't think it's together with this collection because it has some bright pink bows on it, and the dress itself doesn't have any bright pink. I don't care, maybe actually it's not even Angelique Pretty. I don't know why I thought it would be Angelique Pretty socks. It may not be because there's nothing, they look brand new. Okay, they're still attached. And here, so they basically have never been worn, and they are definitely not Angelique Pretty, but I don't mind. I thought they would be Angelique Pretty, but they are not. That's fine, they're very pretty, and actually this pink is a little bit more bright compared to the pink that I usually wear. I don't think it would go well with this dress because the pink is way lighter, but maybe, let me see, maybe it will go with the Romantic Rose Letter or some other ones. But anyways, it has very nice pattern, some lace, the big bright pink bows, and some hearts. The lace and hearts are in white, and the top is very nice too, like some kind of ruffled in this knitted pattern, and it's cute. in white and mint. Okay, mint socks, basically. I have only super colorful and mint tights and also mint and chocolate tights. But since I don't have any mint and pink tights, those are super cool. Or socks, so yay. Head bow first. Okay, you can see it here. It's the purple label of Angelique Pretty. And so Angelique Pretty has two labels, either pink or purple. And the dresses that have the purple label is more for an older kind of Lolita's crowd. And so this is because this dress has some print, you will see, but it's kind of transparent. And so it's more, I won't say casual, but maybe more adult or something, and not bright pink sweet style. Big colorful thing. Even though it's still very sweet, you'll see it's a carousel. I mean, the sweetest. But yeah, so you see the label here, and it has the bow, is a very nice bow. It has no boning, but it has some kind of veil, chiffon veil attached to it. Let me see. Okay, it's attached, so you cannot move the sides. But because of the veil, it would have no point of putting it on top of the head. I think this one I can. No, this one I cannot either. Okay, so let's try it. I love it. It's so elegant. This, I love both on the sides. I love it. And with the chiffon, it's so classic and so elegant. It's gorgeous. I love it. Oh my god, the bow already. I love it. So I'm sorry, I'm looking at the viewfinder and not at you because I want to see it on me. Awesome. I love it. Okay, let's see the dress. The dress is very pretty. Okay, I'm thinking that I will fit in this because I checked. Usually I have some bad experiences sometimes, but this one I checked and yes, it is fully shirt. And for AP to release an OP fully shirt, it's so rare. So this is definitely plus size friendly. I don't remember the measurements, but you can check on Low Library. Also, it has super light sleeves, like transparent and very short, like these. I'm so sorry, this JSK, I love it, but it's so uncomfortable and keep falling. So I thought that maybe, I don't really love usually OPs because it has the sleeves and you cannot coordinate it with a blouse like you would do with a JSK. And so since this one has very transparent and light and short sleeves, I thought that maybe I have to try if it's feasible and not too ugly at the collar or something, maybe I could wear a blouse underneath and that will allow me more freedom and more creativity. That's what I don't like in OPs usually, is that it's just one way to wear it, and even this one has only one color. So it has a matching bow, and so it's so difficult to make so many different coordinates with that. So that's why usually I don't buy OPs, and I prefer JSKs to be more creative. Okay, let's look at this dress. So basically it's all mint, and you can see it's transparent. And so you can see the design, it's Shadow Dream Carnival. Like it's a shadow because it's transparent and you can only see from super close, you see the design, when from far away, you don't really see it. So that makes it more, I don't know, versatile or anything, but very pretty and simple. Yes, simple. Even though it's an OP, it's not like terribly OTT or anything. It is still mint, so it's kind of, it's visible from afar, but really pretty. And so, yeah, maybe we can twin with Roselyn now. Oh, this is chiffon, the bow here. It's so pretty. I love how it falls. Yeah, you can definitely see Angelique Pretty usually has super pretty shapes of bows and they all stick very pretty. Yeah, that's the quality that you get, always fully lined. Oh, I used to love these, you know, like you can cross them in the front, like on your chest, and attach it on your back, like on your neck. I used to love it and I think it's very pretty, but it's very uncomfortable because either it's super tight and you cannot breathe and it's holding you super high and tight, or you make it looser so it's more comfortable and then it falls and it's, yeah. So if you have tips for that, I would like to hear them. Okay. So let me see the inside of the dress. Oh, okay. So basically the lining is all white and you have just the transparent chiffon fabric. It's really pretty. Okay, it looks like the fabric is like, heat pressed and cut out. The design is cut out on a different fabric, heat pressed on the chiffon. And so if you look super closely, it looks like each of the sides of the design could fray and get a little bit damaged. So I don't know how this dress will be after a few wear or washes. So I would say it's a very delicate dress. Ooh, I love the lace. So it's lace with a cross that says AP, very pretty. And it has a layer of a ruffled chiffon, and together that makes it super, super pretty. And it's attached to the lining, which is not very commonly seen, but I like it too. So then you kind of have like three layers at the bottom. Very nice. So many different laces. Here, the lace has some kind of stars in it. That's pretty. And the cross again. Oh yeah, because there's a cross here. Yeah, usually Angelique Pretty makes it very obvious and very pretty to add the lace in the same patterns. And so you have crosses here and here and all the carousel ponies. They're actually unicorns. Carousel unicorns. Yay. Oh, and this is a Pegasus. This is, okay, this is a, okay, there's a word for Pegasus unicorns. I don't remember it. Anyways, stars and moons and yay. Gorgeous, gorgeous. I love it. I love it. So the pattern is very pretty. All the chiffon is very pretty. This is very pretty. So far, I'm super excited by this dress. And that's funny because usually the dresses that I fall in love most, I'm kind of underwhelmed when I see them in person, but this one, I had seen it in person first at Rosalind's. I think she has the exact same one. And also, I was not that much into that dress and I just bought it because I thought it was pretty but not like my dream dress. And actually, it happened several times that I was more excited about dresses that I was less excited of when I saw the pictures than that. So yeah, don't put too much expectations on the dresses when you only see like a tiny picture, even though you sometimes see more like stock pictures. When you see the dress in person, that's really different. Let me tell you about the coordinate that I'm wearing right now, and then I will change into the dress and tell you more how it fits and everything. So I'm wearing this, also a special set from Angelique Pretty. It's Eternal Carnival from Angelique Pretty. It's the special set in mint. I had the head bow. This is a head bow that goes with it. I love special sets because usually you get the head bow with it, and when you buy it secondhand, usually people keep the head bow together with it. And if you don't buy it together when they release, like if it's separate, then it's a pain to find it like secondhand separately. So special sets are amazing because usually they have the head bow or the bonnet or something with it. Even though it's like less creativity to put it together, usually I do. When I have the official head bow, I put them together, but I add a ton of more accessories with it so I can still be creative. But I would appreciate to have the option to have the official thing if I can, and even though I want to do go with something else. But those, when they're imprinted, like this one, for example, I don't see myself wearing it with any other dresses because it's just the exact same print. But this one maybe, because it's very subtle, the print. So maybe this one I can totally wear with this dress. It's amazing. So this one is gold because you can wear it with other dresses. Okay, the head bow from Angelique Pretty. And those two clips are actually, where is it, the other one? I don't remember. I think they came with dresses that I bought from Wish and accessories maybe. And this necklace is also from Angelique Pretty. And this is from Hatitz Art. And this is from Candy Zombie. This is handmade by my friend Aurélie. Those are from Angelique Pretty. And this is from Groovy Roo. The blouse is from Lady Sloth. I love this blouse so much. I just got it like maybe less than a month ago and I've already worn it 3 or 4 times. I just needed a blouse in pink. And yeah, because I did not have any pink blouses in my wardrobe, even though I love mint and pink. And I have so many mint blouses in cutsews and cardigans, but none in pink. So I needed it, and the fact that I wore it so much really showed how much I needed it. So I actually consider buying other blouses in pink because I love it. And yeah, those blouses from Lady Sloth are amazing and super comfy. Okay, and this wig is actually my favorite wig from Wish. And it's all damaged now and I should take care of it more. Okay, let's change into the dress. So, I think it fits perfectly. I think it's very comfortable. The waist is actually kind of low. My right waist is here, but usually it's like right under the boobs, and here I feel like it's more comfortable than usual. And like always, the OPs, it's a little bit tight here, but not too a problem. Maybe it will get better, but at least it's not that it's too tight that it's uncomfortable. It's very pretty. I think the shape is very nice, the shape of the bodice, and it's very comfortable for an OP. I think it's very, very nice, and have a Disney princess vibe here. I don't know, with the top. And I think this necklace works perfectly with it because the bow is also set in perfectly aligned. I like it very much. I'm so happy I got this dress. Like I said, usually it's the dresses that you don't expect that actually become very one of your favorites. So I'm so happy I got this one. The waist eye situation is a little bit sad because the back is like plain white and the front is the mint chiffon, so you really have to do it super pretty, which I did not do. I just did them in my bag, but you have to do them very pretty, unless it's gonna be very ugly, and I don't like that. I prefer when they're like both sided with the fabric, so then you can just put them almost the way you want and it looks okay. And also the socks. The socks, actually, you would not even say they are underneath socks. You know, there's OTK is like over the knee socks, and under knee socks come just under your knee, but those come mid-calf. So this is super weird. Also, the top that is ruffled part is really not very pretty. And so I like ankle socks, or at least under the knee or over the knee, but those mid-calf socks, I don't know what to do with them. And they will definitely just fall, or maybe you have to wear them like leg warmers at your ankle or something like that, because that's how they will end up anyways. So I don't know, this is weird, but I mean, it was worth the pack, and I was not buying the lot for that. I was buying it for the dress and the head bow. So yeah. And to go back on why do we buy more dresses, I think also in Lolita there's the things of let's collect all the dresses or something like that. And I've always been a collector at heart. I've many collections, and I have, maybe you've seen on my channel, my doll collection, Cherry Muffins, that also completely randomly look like Lolitas. Anyways, I love to collect pretty things and have them, but I also love to wear my clothes. And there's a lot of dresses that I did not like that I'm okay to let go to buy more stuff that I can wear and use. So I think I'm getting good at this. to only keep the things that I love, even though I buy a lot of dresses. I might also sell a lot of them because either they're too small or I just don't like them, so I just want them to go somewhere else so somebody else can wear it and love it, and don't keep it in my closet if I don't like it. And I feel okay about buying more dresses because I'm not buying any other normal clothes. And unless it's something that I need, like right now my sneakers are completely broken, the ones that I wear every day, and I need a new one, so I bought new ones. But I'm not like buying jeans and t-shirts and stuff like that. So I'm usually not buying more normal clothes and saving all my money for Lolita. And I sold so many stuff from my house this Christmas break. We went through every single thing we owned in the whole house and got rid of so many stuff, and a lot of things I sold, and I got a bunch of money to buy Lolita. So now I don't feel bad about spending money for Lolita because I actually sold things that were not useful or exciting or things that I didn't need anymore in my life to get more Lolita, like this pretty dress. So I think it's a perfect deal. Awesome. So I want you to know, you guys, why do you buy more dresses and what makes you buy more dresses in Lolita, and do you have a theme or something? Tell me about your buying habits in Lolita. And if you enjoyed me unboxing this video, I have a whole playlist of me unboxing or showing you in hauls every single dress I own in my wardrobe almost. So if you have time, go watch this whole playlist of my dresses. So thank you so much for watching, and remember, everybody can be kawaii. Bye bye.